Our purpose is, let's open our values in the book of Genesis. We want us to read from chapter 3, and we'll start from verse number 1. This is part two of what we began last time. We began to look at victory over Python, and we are having the second part. As God gives us grace to be overcomers. Alright, so if you're there, once again, from verse number 1. The Bible says, now the serpent was more subtle and crafty than any living creature of the field which the Lord God had made. And he, Satan, said to the woman, can it really be that God has said, you shall not eat from every tree of the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat the fruit from the trees of the garden, except the fruit from the tree which is in the middle of the garden. God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. But the serpent said to the woman, you shall not surely die. For God knows in the day of it, your eyes will be opened and you will be like God, knowing the difference between good and evil, and blessing and calamity. When the woman saw that the tree was suitable, pleasant for food, and that it was delightful to look at, and a tree to be desired in order to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she gave some also to her husband, and he ate. And the eyes of them both were open, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together, and made themselves apron like garments. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, where are you? He said, I heard the sound of you walking in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. But he said, who told you that you are naked? Have you eaten of the tree which I commanded you that you should not eat? And the man said, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me from the tree, and I ate. But the Lord God said to the woman, what is this you have done? The woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I ate. And the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you are cursed above all domestic animals and above every wild living thing of the field. Upon your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust, what it contains all the days of your life. Verse 15, and I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and her offspring. He will bruise and tread your head underfoot, and you will lie in wait and bruise his heel. Let's pray. Father, thank you as we look into our, speak to us, Lord. And as we come into prayer, may you empower us, Father, indeed, we may take proper victory over every assignment of the kingdom of darkness against us, even against your church. In Jesus' name we pray, somebody say amen. Amen. All right, let us say we are going back to part number 2 of victory over Python. And as some of you will understand, you are present in our last Friday. And here we are again continuing with this same topic, because Python must die, must let loose and let go from the lives of God's people. Somebody must enter a new season of total victory in their lives. Glory to God. God has not designed mankind to be overcome by any power. He designed you to be an overcomer. Self-designed to be at the top. That is why when God created mankind, he left him for the last. He created everything else. Then finally came man, the ruler of everything. God says that he gave him dominion to rule over everything he has created. And when we see Jesus coming, the Bible says, over everything visible and invisible, it is under his power. So if you're sitting here and you call yourself a man, a human being, I want you to know that through Jesus Christ, God has put the kingdom of darkness under your feet. You are above them. They are under you. If you read the scripture, it says that he will push your heel, but he will crush the head. You will be victorious. Tonight there shall be victory over serpents that have been harassing and tormenting somebody's life. Amen is to you. May you receive an anointing of amen. Say amen. Hallelujah. If you read the word, you find many instances which I began to share with you that every time the serpent reared up the head, they were being beat down. From the Garden of Eden, God said you will crush the head. You come to the book of Deuteronomy, God said, approaching through that wilderness, there were serpents when you came out. In fact, even before they went to the wilderness, the Bible says that when Moses went to Egypt and he was about to redeem the Israelites, the magicians came out. When Moses cast down the rod and they turned into a serpent, they cast their ropes and they turned into serpents. But the Bible says that the rod of Moses, the serpent of Moses, is swallowed up all the other serpents. This is what shall happen in your life tonight. Any satanic rule that has been used to stop your life, it must be stopped tonight. Because there's something called the road of the wicked. Sometimes you can see some things just as roads, but in the realm of the spirit, it's carrying a representation of another power. Hallelujah. And we know that the road of Moses is the road that God used to work all the miracles which he was doing upon the Israelites. Say, my Father, tonight, let me receive the divine road to beat down my enemies in the name of Jesus. The way you are praying, you're not praying like a warrior. Say, my Father, let the anointing of a warrior fall upon me now in the name of Jesus. It's okay you're fasting, but now that fasting cannot be used as an excuse to become wicked. Look at your name and try to be delivered. Hallelujah. Because your spirit man is strong, your flesh is weak, but your spirit is strong. There is no way the flesh and the spirit can be strong together. Only one can be strong. If you strengthen the flesh, you weaken the spirit. If you weaken the flesh, you strengthen the spirit. So right now, you are at your best for you to beat down the powers of darkness. Fire will be proceeding out of you. Tonight, the devil will take fireworks from you. The amen is with. Hallelujah. So everywhere we find that happening, God spoke in the book of Isaiah chapter 27, verse number 1. God speaks and says concerning Leviathan the serpent. And he says that he will destroy the sea serpent. He says he will cut down the sea serpent by the sword. So we find throughout the word of God, the serpent is always being overcome by the people of God. Jesus in Luke 19 spoke about it. He said, you crush the serpent. Hallelujah. Say, I have been given victory over every serpent. So tonight, this principality, this serpent named Python, I began to speak to you about it last time, that it is a chief power, it is a ruling power that controls a large portion of the kingdom of darkness. And I told you all over the world, Python has severely afflicted men. If you can remember last time, I began to give you some characteristics of this spirit. And I will not go much into it, but I can touch it and there so I can set perspective. I'll finish part two of the world, and in a short time, we are going to go into prayer. I spoke to you that Python owns every satanic agent, from his doctors, anyone you find being seeking for God through any other means apart from the Holy Ghost, or seeking also to find God through religion. All of these means, they are controlled by the Python spirit. And I said to you that your ancestors, every one of them, were under Python. That's why, especially in Africa, because Python is a master of lies and has lied to men, has spoken to so many people and taught them many things which are not according to the word of God. And this power has been able to rule our forefathers until now. When you look at the Garden of Eden, and in the book of Genesis, we find the serpent beginning to speak to Adam and Eve, and we find that Eve was deceived. Somebody say deceived. Because one of the spirits in the Python is deception. It's a spirit that comes to twist the word of God. God says something, but the Python or the spirit will twist it. God said, yes, if you eat it, you will die in that day. But Python comes to add something else and says, God knows you will know something else. You will have something else. So it came to deceive them, to make them eat when God already commanded them. Remember, it was a word of God that said, don't eat it. But the serpent or the Python spirit speaks to say, you must eat it. You must go against the word of God. It is a power that is behind every lie. If you find anywhere men are believing on anything that is not written in the word of God, you must know that this serpent spirit, this Python spirit, is behind all of these things from divine and spiritual source. If you're here and you used to read your horoscopes, or even right now when you have your time, you say, oh, let me look at my stars. If you read those, you must know you are feeding off from the Python spirit. Palm readers, they are all under this Python spirit. I spoke to you concerning Python, that is a thief. It is a spirit that collects the stars of people. It collects the blessings of people. When it showed up in the Garden of Eden, it collected the star of Abraham, brother Adam and Eve, and made sure they have been kicked out of the Garden of Eden. They were in a place where everything was well taken care of. But immediately Python operated on them, they were cast out into the place where they were suffering in hardship. And God said, you will now eat by the sweat of your brow. It is a spirit that loves it when you don't know the word of God. It will fight the word of God. Somebody just spoke to me and asked me one or two questions, and I was sharing with them and saying, you know, Python, when you are starting to read the word, it is the one power that will make you to be sleeping. It cannot allow you to read the word. It cannot allow you to pray. Why? Because the word is fire. The prayer is fire. All these things, they burn up the serpent. So this spirit must fight against it to make sure you cannot go into that scripture. Tonight this power shall be broken from your life. Any recipe that was left from last time, it must end tonight in the name of Jesus. I spoke to you that every blood disease is under the Python spirit. And even people who suffer sicknesses like sickle cell, you find somebody for some reason, they are told your blood, red blood cells, I believe they are few in number, and so this is what you must do. I don't know whether they have tablets, they have to take and such like things so that they can boost up their blood levels. But Python is a spirit that will afflict the blood. It injects poison into the blood and poisons the entire life of the person. As you may know it, the serpent, when it has sent the poison, part of the assignment is to go to the heart and make sure the heart has been stopped. And once the heart is stopped, the life has been stopped. I want you to know that the Python spirit does not stop at anything until the life of the person is over. And I told you that every kind of sickness is under the Python spirit. If you find that you are suffering some sickness, you are suffering some disease, which cannot be cured, it cannot be taken care of, even sometimes the doctor cannot be able to decide, you try and say, now, okay, let them do some other examination, and they can't find it. You must know that the serpent spirit is working very hard to stop your destiny. Tonight, any strange disease shall be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall leave suddenly from somebody's life, and you find yourself free. Somebody say, my freedom must manifest tonight. Python swallows the victims. It swallows the blessings. It swallows the factions. It swallows finances. If you find your finances are in trouble, you will try to find how I can eat, but there is struggle. The Python spirit is what you're contending with. It is a power that does not want you to see. It doesn't want to see you enjoying life. Anyone who lives a bitter life, you find that I'm not happy with life. In fact, Python will make you so bitter with life, either of two things will happen. You will want to either take your life, or you will say, I don't want to serve God anymore. Why? Because of introducing bitterness into the life of a person. Tonight, that bitterness will leave your life. God did not design you to be bitter. He designed you to live a sweet life and to be a sweet child of God. Hallelujah. You come to church, somebody says, I said, don't talk to me. Now what? You are a child of God. You are in the house of God. The people of God are known to be happy. You need to carry joy on your face. Hallelujah. But the time has pressed on, you don't want to see anyone. Because it has made your life bitter. This bitterness will leave tonight. It will leave tonight. It will leave tonight. Anything that connects you to God, Python will fight it. And I spoke to you that anyone who is not dreaming, Python has already operated you. If you find that you say, oh, man of God, I bless the Lord, at least I don't dream. I used to dream a long time ago, but now I don't dream. Because the dreams used to be bad, now I don't dream at all. The last 1 year, somebody who spoke to me and said that for the span of about a year, they could not remember any single dream. You sleep, you wake up, the night is over. Sleep, wake up, the night is over. No dream and no bother. Somebody say fire. It's the power that will make sure you don't dream. And if you dream, it will make sure you forget the dream. So you wake up, you say, oh, what was that dream? You cannot remember your dream. Tonight you must pray very seriously. By the time this power has let you go, because I don't will attack the mind. Somebody say the mind. By the time tonight we have prayed and this power has let you go, you will remember every dream in your life.
Amen.
Python will make sure no visions in your life, no dream in your life, no revelation in your life. I spoke to you that poverty is controlled by Python. In fact, in this house I have shared with many of you of 7 powers that are under Python. And if you notice them in your life, you must know that you need to pray hard against this spirit. And even if it happens in a dream life, you have dreams, you see yourself carrying backwardness in your dreams, because backwardness is one of them. Stagnation is another one of them. Witchcraft is another one of them. Poverty is another one. Frustration is another one. Infirmity is another one. And joblessness is also another one. Anyone who has any of these things manifesting in their lives, they should not miss their time in praying against the Python spirit. You must pray so hard, and you must pray with fire, because this power must break and it must let you go. I said, God designed for you to be wealthy, to be prosperous. Amen. Look at where God put Adam and Eve. You think God could keep them out of a nice place? When he created them, he did not just say, now you go to that earth and live there. He gave them a very nice place to live. Eden. Everything was stated for. Everything was okay. When God beat them up, he said, out of there, you will now eat by the sweat of your brow. Hard life. Hard life. Experiencing hard life, you must pray to break the Python spirit. So this power engineered it that they were kicked out of the place of comfort that God designed for them. Tonight somebody will be restored back to Eden. I said, you're coming back to Eden.
Amen.
You're coming back to Eden. You know, sometimes you can have lived so far from Eden that when you go the way back to Eden, you say, you know, I'm used to living here now. I said, God is helping you. You are moving from that neighborhood to a posh neighborhood. You say, I'm used to this place. Again, my friends are missing. What are you talking about, man of God? God will bless you. You're going to drive your own big car. You say, man of God, I like the public transport. I'm used now to pushing and showing people. I will miss it. That lifestyle. You know, in the car, you are alone. You have your own car. You are just by yourself. That's why you put music to comfort you. Hallelujah. But it is better than pushing and shoving with devil worshippers and satanic agents. Some of them, you enter the transport, I'm sure you know, they look at you fine. Say, this one today, I'm sitting with another one. You must be delivered from that.
Amen.
You drive your own car, your big car, not small car, big car, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Somebody say, tonight, all my blessings must manifest.
Must manifest.
God designed you for a comfortable life, a good life, a blessed life. Let me remind you about your life. Let me remind you about the things that God has designed for you. Because sometimes you have been so used to living a certain lifestyle, you don't know who you really are. You are royalty. You are a child of the King. You are designed for a good life. At work life, you are designed to be a king. You are designed to be the head and not the tail. Anywhere you see someone as a leader, that's where you should be. Glory to God. But the power that will make sure you are not up there, Python is number one. It hurts anywhere God's people can prosper. That's why when Python is done with you, it squeezes a life out of you and makes sure you are dead. It cannot give up until you're dead. I spoke to you last time about a certain family, and this Python spirit began to grow. He said, this family, anyone who dies, I am responsible. They don't just die, I'm the one who kills them. Look at that. So you can be looking at people and say, oh, that person died. But the serpentine spirit is busy making sure they are dead. Tonight, that kind of pattern will be reversed out of your life, out of your family, out of your generation. People will live to 100 years old. You see, you cannot say amen because 40 years, 50 years has been the order of the day. It's a man of God. How is it possible? People are living there for about 100 years. It is something that God wants to happen. Praise the Lord. I refuse to leave this earth before my time in the name of Jesus. I told you, Python will love to flatter you. It's a flattering spirit that you will become like God, but it didn't actually become like God. You lied to them. Yes, they knew good and evil, but they became like God. In fact, they lost the glory. Immediately they ate the fruit. They were being covered. They were clothed by the glory. If you are wondering how come they ate and they suddenly decided to see fig leaves, it's because people were walking in the glory. They were clothed with the glory. About people sometimes who have seen in the realm of the spirit, they are used to me in the physical, no problem. The day they saw me now, they start fearing me. They start walking away. They ask me, who are you? Who are you? Somebody else is there in the transport. And they stop the car. And they look at me and say, who are you? Why? Because God opened their eyes. They saw my spirit man. Glorious. Somebody say glory. Here and there, God will open people's eyes. They will see and say, I've seen something I've never seen before. Now, I want you to know that before, this glory was not just in the spirit, it was also in the physical. So when they ate the fruit, you see, Eve was deceived, but Adam ate the fruit knowing he was not deceived. Glory to God. You've eaten the fruit. He said, yes, my husband, I've eaten the fruit. Please, just have some. But you know, God said, you just have some. When he ate it like this, immediately they became aware. Adam sinned, but Eve was deceived. Hallelujah. It's a mystery right there. Because Adam could have been Eve. If he had offered himself, he said, now, let me become the salvation of my own wife, he could have been Eve. But he didn't do it. He also ate it. That's why God sent second Adam, the Lord Jesus Christ, now to redeem his wife, the bride, the church. Hallelujah. And Jesus did not mess up. He did not mingle. When the serpent appeared, again, not in the Garden of Eden, but in the wilderness, and again in the Garden of Gethsemane, to try and move him away from the assignment of God. Jesus overcame, and because of that, we are now back in the kingdom. Somebody say, I'm back. Say it again, I'm back. Because the devil had removed us from dominion, but Jesus came to bring us back into that dominion. So the serpent lied to them and took away their blessing. I said to you, Python is behind laziness and lazy people. Somebody who has done nothing. It's only morning time. You hear somebody saying, I'm tired. I'm very tired. Well, how can you be tired? You just came from sleeping. Now you're tired. It's Python that is working on you. After taking prayers over Python's spirit, I've had testimonies of people came and say, man of God, they can't believe what happened. I said, what happened? They said to me, now I woke up in the morning, something that has not been had. People, they ask me, like, we didn't know you can see. Because they woke up now energized, strong, singing, walking in the kitchen. And everybody is wondering, hey, what is going on today? Because the way we know this person, they will wake up 9, 10, 11 a.m. At 6 a.m. you're already up. Hallelujah. Would you like the strength to come back? Tonight, pray very seriously. This type of spirit must break from your life. It will not put you tired when you're not tired. It will not make you procrastinate when you should not procrastinate. You will do it at the right time. Glory to God. It must break tonight. Heaviness It's an assignment from the Python spirit. I said to Satan, when this serpent has coiled itself around you in the realm of the spirit, now it bolts you down. It bolts you down. You cannot move. You can't do anything. What must happen is it must be broken from your life. Insanity, mental problems, depression, paranoia, all these are things that are under the Python spirit. If you see somebody has gone insane, mad, praise God. And I think you know it, because there's a statement that says every marketplace has its own madman. So you must have gone to a marketplace by this time, and you saw a madman. You say, what's wrong with this person? Your mom told you, this is a madman. He's the one who owns this marketplace. So the devil puts all the demons in them. Anyone who comes to buy, they harass those people. If there is anyone with insanity in your family, if you have suffered mental problems, if there is depression that has hit your life, Python is the power you must pray. You must pray from your life. Paranoia. Paranoia is irrational, I believe it's irrational fears. Something is not there. You see somebody saying, somebody is chasing me, but when you look to see, there is no one chasing them. They are seeing their own things, imagining their own things. Even sometimes they can be stating their own things. You have not spoken anything negative about them, but they say, you see now the way you are talking about me. You don't like me, you hate me now. I don't say. It introduces misunderstanding into relationships. Glory to God. We must pray tonight. You will not be paranoid that you don't have paranoid people around you. In fact, if you see somebody paranoid around you, just command that Python and tell him, Python is this person. You see them jumping up and scaring themselves. You say, what did you say? You tell them, I set you free. Amen. So, quickly, how do you know that Python is in your life? Let me pray. Chronic poverty. You are so poor that you cannot even buy matchstick. You have to go to your neighbor. You strategize. How do I go? Because yesterday I asked them for 5 sticks. Today I'm still going back. I can't do this thing. Chronic poverty. The shoe you are wearing in January is the same shoe in December you're wearing. Hallelujah. Same shoe, everywhere, every time. Python. The clothing you wear, people are used to it. When they see even in a crowd, they know it's you. Without returning back, they can call you by your name. And you will respond because they know you are the one. Oh, your wardrobe, the people, they know it. From tonight, your wardrobe will change. You have the wardrobe they don't know. Hallelujah. Two, overweight problems that refuse to go away. Overweight. You do the gym and you've seen them. Treat me, everything. Sometimes, you know, sometimes God will just open my eyes, I can discern in the spirit, and I can tell this one is not an eating problem, it's a serpent problem. The serpent is inside. What is inside? You know, Bible is a big serpent. So it makes people to bloat up. Once it leaves, all that weight will fall down. So they are praying over a certain lady, and the Python spirit goes inside. He said, I am putting all the weight on this person. Immediately the serpent went, the weight, she began to take a normal shape. Somebody say normal shape. Yes. A normal shape is not of God, it's of the kingdom of darkness. Amen. Amen. Can't say amen there. Are you counting yourself as abnormal? You're in the right place. If that is you. Confused fellow. Confused fellow. Or confusion. You look at the person, you wonder, what's wrong with this person? Everything is confused in the life of the person. If you find you're confused, you don't know this, you don't know that. This is there, you left something here, you left it there. You forgot so many things. You don't do things in the right way. You keep on asking yourself, what is wrong with me? The Python spirit is the spirit behind confusion. Python works closely with the Bible. Like I said to you, this is a water spirit. That means it comes from the water. Leviathan also comes from the water. They leave the water and they go to the land to afflict men. Once they're done, they return to their water. If they are called for, they leave the water. That's why I told you all the witch doctors and whoever else, they will be moving towards water bodies because this spirit is right there. In this country, you know, Mombasa is very famous. Somebody will say they are going to get Majini from the coast or something like that. Deaths in the family. It's another sign of Python being present. You buried yesterday, you tell the people, now, brethren, I am sorry again, I must announce that somebody else has died. So you become a bearer of bad news. Or your family is used to the bad news. You know, there are people, they are so used to bad news. It's become normal for them. When they hear somebody has died, you don't see them crying anymore. Because they cry forever. If somebody dies in your family, you cry from morning to night, 7 days. And so then they say, it's a very bad thing when it's a burial day. If that is happening to you already, you must know something is wrong somewhere. Glory to God. God did design you that you are burying people every month. Somebody in your family is dying. They are calling you, giving you news of death in the family. You must rise up and command the Python spirit to release your family members. Glory to God. Somebody say, I am my family. We shall live in Jesus' name. Backwardness is another sign of Python. Backwardness, emotion. You were up there. Your life has been brought down there. Backwardness. There are some things you used to be able to do before. Right now, you cannot do them. Some places you could go before, right now you cannot go there. Some things you could buy before, right now you cannot buy them. Backwardness has come into the life. Python must be fought in such a life. Frustration, I already mentioned it to you. You live a frustrated life. You are frustrated with everything. Frustrated with people. Frustrated with things. You even become frustrated with God. Somebody who begins to question God. They say, now, if you are in my life, I should not be suffering like this. Somebody say, Python. It will frustrate your life until you think the problem is God. But God is not the problem. The problem is you and the Python spirit. Glory to God. Frustration. God showed me this demon. Frustration is not a big spirit. It's a small demon. Small. It's like, it's not small like this, but I liken it to the mosquito that is in your bedroom when you're trying to sleep and you cannot locate it. When you turn off the light, it starts singing. When you turn on the light, it stops. You turn it off, it sings. On, it stops. The whole night, when you feel this one, the other one has started. Somebody say frustration. It's something you cannot see. It's somewhere around by, but you cannot be able to get a hold of it. It frustrates you. So if you find that you are living a frustrated life, there are small things that are getting at you. You must fight this spirit. Non-existent prayer life will show you that Python is right there. You only pray when you come to church on Friday and on Sunday. The rest of the week, the prayer chamber does not know you. God was asked to give a testimony about the prayer life. He will say, we don't talk these days. Hallelujah. We can tell him and ask the neighbor, how is your prayer life? Python will give you a prayer life dead, non-existent, gone. Stagnation. Stagnated life. Where they left you 5 years ago is where you still are today. The other one is joblessness. I spoke to you. You try to find that job, you will not be able to find it. Everywhere you can, you have all the papers, you have every qualification. In fact, you are overqualified, more than other people, but still will not hire you. Tonight you must pray, and this power must let you go. And I'm speaking to somebody trusting God for a better job. It is coming from tonight in the name of Jesus. Python will render your hands inactive. It will put weights on your hands. Most of the people who are jobless, they don't know. But there are weights. Sometimes I pray for people, I see weights that are hard on the hands. And the devil say, these hands will do nothing. Tonight those weights will disappear. I said, find a very gifted person. He said, this person, he can do so much, but they are not doing it. What is happening? Python is stopping them. Strange and incurable diseases. And I've already spoken to you about it. Every sickness that you know upon this earth is under the Python spirit. Anyone look and say, sickness, medicine, medication. You have a cabinet, when you open it, everybody goes like, because you have every medication. In fact, your house now is a chemist. When people are unwell, you know what to prescribe to them. You tell them that for this condition, you need to go and buy a medicine, methylpropane, something. Hallelujah. You know every medical term. Now even people are confused when you start talking about medication. You must be delivered from Bible. Unless you are a doctor, you have no right to know certain names of medication. You know, somebody can shock you with the name of medicine. They can name something before you and you're shocked. You're like, is that even available in chemists in this country? Yet it is. They tell you, yeah, it's a painkiller. As for us, you know, painkillers are Panadol, and the others, they know even deeper names. If that is happening to you, Python. People who have head sicknesses and diseases, every time it's headaches, if right now in your back you have Panadol or painkillers, because sometimes your head just goes off like this, Python. Hallelujah. He must pray for your life. God did not design you to swallow painkillers as if they are food. You eat food, you leave the medicine to the sick people. Can I get an amen? Headaches, migraines, all of these things, Python. Broken relationships, Python. It's a spirit that came between Adam and Eve and separated them. It put some brokenness between them because now they could not understand one another. Chronic lying. A lot of people could lie like a dog or like an envelope. It's too bad. Hallelujah. Chronic lying. Look at your neighbor, ask the neighbor. Do you lie sometimes? As a neighbor, do you know somebody who lies? You cannot exhaust one day without telling 1, 2, 3 lies. You need deliverance from Bible. You're in the right place. Glory to God. Lying, it will land you into the pit of hell. Together with other things, powers that Jesus and the Lord God have said that's their home. Segregation. Segregation is another sign of Python in your life, where you do not attend church anymore. You find somebody who say, now I'm not going to church anymore. Python. It will separate you to make sure it has cut you down. Such a person, you must pray very hard for them, because by that time this serpent is working hard on them. I already spoke to you about not remembering your dreams, is Python as well. Costly mistakes is Python. as well. You make a mistake, you cannot recover from it. This is final. Dream attacks. You cannot have a comfortable dream. Every time, attacks upon attacks in your dream life. You can't wake up and say, oh wow, what a nice dream. What a beautiful day. You open your curtain singing, not closing them crying. You say, I must go back to bed. The dream was so bad. Tonight is your night of deliverance. Those satanic dreams should leave your life. Hallelujah. You should not have wake up. Sunday, party. Thank Jesus. It was only a dream. Python is behind every manner of negative dreams that come up against people. No real progress in life. Python. Huge financial losses. Python. You start a business and you say, this business is what will move me forward. The business goes down with all your money. You go and borrow money. You come and invest in the business. It goes down with it. Now you are only left with huge debts. The one power that must break from your life is fighter, because it's a swallower of finances. Glory to God. Always coming last. After everybody else has done, finally you arrive. If you are the last one to arrive. Python. Living a bitter life. You are bitter with life. You don't see anything good in you. When people laugh, it annoys you. What are they laughing about? Tonight you are about to know what they are laughing about. Because you'll be laughing yourself. Hallelujah. When this power breaks from your life, you know why they're laughing. Amen. Do you know life can be that hard? It can be that difficult. In fact, people now are laughing out of joy. You think they're laughing at you. Because people don't laugh anymore, according to your own book. Lack of good things for long periods is also time. You spent a long time. Since January until now, when somebody asks you, do you have my testimony? You say, man of God, I'm still waiting for my testimony. I believe in September it shall be delivered. Surely as a testimony is coming forth for you. In the name of Jesus. And it's a big amen. I just realized that, you know, yesterday I saw the vision, the numbers tripling. And I was just looking at it and it was just there, standing there. It was just there for a while. Then when it was taken away, I asked the Lord, what you're showing me? And God began to speak to me about new beginnings that are coming to many people who are in this fast. I'm telling you, you surprise people after this fast. You surprise people. There are things that you didn't expect that can happen in your life. They suddenly happen in your life. They say, ah, I didn't know it. Even you are among the people who are going to fly out of the country. You fly out. Somebody say new things.
New things.
People will get jobs that have 6 zeros. Even 7 zeros out of this fast. God will remember you big time. Hallelujah. And even tonight as you're praying, this is a night to unlock the good things, because Python will lock every good thing from your life. Now you have nothing good. There are people I have invited to come to church, a certain lady. I've been invited her for 3 years to arrive in this church. She has never come. Not that she does not want to come. She tells the man of God, I don't have the fear to come. And besides, my leg right now is having a problem. It's been sick for all this time. So she cannot move, and even that fear, she cannot get it. 3 years, she has not arrived here. The day she will come, I tell you, I will show you, this is the woman I was talking to you about. Hallelujah. I'll quickly speak to you about how can you be victorious over Python. And we go into prayer. 5 minutes I'll be done with how you can be victorious. Then we go into prayer. Number one, you want victory over Python, you must rediscover the word. Go back to the basics. The truth is what will drive out the lie. Remember, Python is a lying spirit. It's a spirit of deception. If you want to deceive you about everything that God has seen, So if you want to live the life, you must go back to the world. Be a student of the world. A student of the world, it will never be able to approach. Jesus, when tempted by the serpent in the wilderness, he said, "It is written, it is written, it is written." And he took total victory over the serpent. The same thing will happen to you when you know the world. In fact, I saw in the spirit that the more of the world you have, the longer the soul you have, or the more powerful your soul is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not everybody has the same power of the soul in the spirit. There are some people, the soul is small like this, because they don't know anything. They just have a knife, a pen knife. You scratch the devil like this. When they tell you to read your Bible, they don't read it. You are a scratcher. That's what you are. But you never tell them to be delivered. Other people, it's a long sword. They can fight even from here. The devil being at the back of the church can smack the devil. And long sword, we can fight from far. Hallelujah. Read the Bible, become strong. Even the devil will know you in the realm of the spirit. Because when he knows you know the word, he will not come to tempt you. He said, this one, they will go to the word and be forced to move away from their lives. Know the word. Number two, use your spiritual authority. Luke 10:19. I already quoted it for you. Mark 16:18. He says they will pick up serpents. So that means you have power over the serpent. It should not scare you. We should scare it instead. Amen. And in Luke, he says he will trample on serpents. So you step on them. Use your authority. Don't say, Jesus, come and step on this serpent for me. No. He said, you will trample. Look at your name and say, you. He didn't say, then the Lord God will come from heaven and crush the head of the serpent. He said, you will trample. So you use your authority. When you see the serpent, you tell the serpent, hear my voice, I'm on the feet. Amen. Number three, understand your spiritual weapons. The only language that serpents understand is fire. Holy Ghost, fire. The blood of Jesus. This, when you know this kind of weapons, there is no serpent that can overcome you. You will unleash the blood of Jesus and they will suddenly flee away from you. Amen. And the serpent in fact is overturned by the blood of Jesus. God told me, because when I began to minister in deliverance, I see bites on people. When you look at them in the physical, everybody is okay. But in the spirit, I see parts of them. God said to me, release the blood of Jesus and wipe out all those serpentine bites. Tonight, some of you will be beaten by serpents, not in the physical, but in the spirit. The blood of Jesus will wash it away from you. Hallelujah. Why? Because if the serpent bite is still there, it is a mark, an evil mark put on you. So every time they want to betray you, they can find it. Tonight, they will lose your address in the name of Jesus. Number four, take deliverance. There are sometimes it is not just fighting and doing prayer warfare. When you realize it is too much, take deliverance for it. Because like I told you, you are dealing with a strong man power. It is not easy to finish it off unless yourself, God has transformed you into a strong man as well. Next, develop a rich prayer life. When your prayer life is hot and on fire, no serpent will touch you. Because every time they want to come close to you, they will say, we can't touch that on their fire. I've had many instances where the minister did first. And I ask the spirit, so now you've been attacking this one. What about the wife? What about the husband? They will say, no, we cannot touch them. Why can't you touch them? They say, those of they are fire. They pray too much. They harass our kingdom too much. So somebody who knows how to pray is somebody who is on fire. Hallelujah. You protect yourself when you do that. Next, seek God for yourself. There's our two more. Seek God for yourself. You don't love prophets and you don't love people coming to prophesy to you or even you prophesying too much. Seek God. Let God speak to you for you. Don't be somebody says, man of God, I need a prophetic word. My most likely inclination is I will not prophesy to you. I'll just talk to you. I'll prophesy to you when God says prophesy. Hallelujah. So, seek God for yourself. Don't be somebody says a new prophet has come, all of these things, they will land you onto the lap of Python. And the last one, do not have itching ears. Wanting to hear what is comfortable for you or to you. Don't have that, those kind of ears. When somebody rebukes you, you cannot take the rebuke. Be a child of God who can be rebuked. Amen. Say, my Father, anytime I must be rebuked, rebuke me very seriously. That is how you grow as a child of God. But now if you only want to be comfortable, oh God shall bless you. But if you don't, now you must repent. You are in sin. You must repeat that person. You say, now you are not becoming my friend. You must take deliverance as a person. Must be delivered. That's why you find now even some people, their ears, they become infected. And some people, their ears, they are popping sounds in the ear. When that is happening, you know Python has been attacking you because that spirit, it attacks your hearing. You don't hear God well, now you hear the other side. Hallelujah. Tonight, Python must die. I didn't tell you, amen.
Amen.
Oh, you are having plans of letting the spirit survive? If please, you are having those plans, raise your hand where you are. So tonight, Python must die. Somebody say, must die. Rise on your feet. I want to take you to serious prayers, 20 minutes, and you'll be out of this place. So you must pray like a wounded lion. Because I know some of you are hungry, I must let you go so you can go and eat. Please, let's say this in your section. I don't want you to fall here. He said, that man of God, he put us in prayer. I fell down. No, 20 minutes. Oh, that's all I need of the time. And this final spirit must expire from your life. So you must pray, fire, fire, fire. And then, amen. All right, moving to this little section, don't worry about your back. We have ushers, the church is safe and secure. Everything will be okay for you. Just move into the middle section, raise your hands to heaven. Be surrender to God. It's time to be down this power. It's time to command every grief that has had upon your life to bring the name of Jesus. To bring banana. Come on, just raise your hands to heaven. First thing I want to do is repent. Ask God to forgive you. Anytime you have entertained the Python spirit, can you open your mouth where you are and tell the Lord that I am repenting for entertaining this spirit in my life. Every time I open the door for this spirit in my life, I am repenting right now. Come on, somebody, wherever you are. Just speak to God. Speak to God. Speak to God. Speak to God. Maybe you discover you are complaining too much. Speak to God and tell the Lord, I am repenting of this thing. You discover, you go against the authority of God, you walk in disobedience with what? Don't say don't do it, you are done. Tell God, I am repenting. Because any time you disobey the word of God, you are going into the title, spirit zone. Come on, open the mouth where you are, and speak to God and tell him, Lord, I am repenting. For every time I have disobeyed your command, disobeyed your word, every time I walk in sin, every time I open the door, I am repenting right now. Let the blood of Jesus wash me, cleanse me right now. Speak to God. Maybe there are altars in your family. There are altars that you walk into, altars of witchcraft. Speak to God and tell him, Lord, I am repenting for consulting. I am repenting for stepping on those altars. I am repenting in the behalf of my family. I know my grandparents. I know my parents are very deep in witchcraft. I am repenting right now. We open the door. Come on, son. Put repentance. Put repentance, put repentance, because this cup cannot come back to accuse you. The reason why it's a prayer so long is because the devil can see. But this person is asking, but they have something that belongs to me. Come on, something where you are. Speak to God and tell him, Lord Jesus, I am repenting. Every open door, every opportunity, give it to this spirit. Wherever you've been lazy, tell God, I've been lazy. I open the door, I am repenting. Come on, somebody where you are. Come on, somebody where you are. Somebody pray the Holy Ghost for me. Rabba ni ti ti ti. Hanama ti ti ti. Ribba ka na 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 na. Ninyan ka ka. Rabba. in Tanti,
in my father's house, all that's on something that's serious, in my mind.
immediately go. Arise. Locate every tiny place of a tiny story in my house, in my village, in my family. I learned something into pieces. 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 Now, in the name of Jesus, say you, the Lord of God, arise. Swallow every serpent and spirit in my family. Swallow every serpent and spirit in my workplace. Swallow every serpent and spirit in my village. Now, in the name of Jesus, say I'm filled up by the sword of my mouth. I cut off the head of every serpent and spirit.
I'm not sure.
2024, I command you, release it on God. 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 Now, in the name of Jesus, say, Holy Ghost fire, arise, arrest every serpent. Holy Ghost fire, arise, arrest the Bible spirit. Of debts, every evil load, of failure, every evil
Come on! Let's continue thanking God. Let's continue.